Welcome to What's the 411, your smart source for urban lifestyle and entertainment news. I'm Kizzy Cox.
And I'm Onika McLean.
Hey, hi. How are you?
We have celebrations. Everybody clap your hands. Turn off a black girl magic. Oh. Kizzy Cox, congratulations on your award with the National Black Journalism Award. Right? Tell us about it a little bit.
Yes, thank you so
Kizzy
much.
So Kizzy wasn't here, and so we couldn't be with you guys because we had to support her in her travel.
Thank you. Yes. So I won a Salute to Excellence Award for NABJ for a radio story I did about criminal justice.
Yeah.
So that was really, really, really like a good honor. I was like, oh my gosh. It was, yeah, it was great.
And being in front of all of you. You know, you guys like know that Kizzy is power to the doggone people. She do it for the culture. So if you guys can find that radio interview, we'll attach the link.
Okay.
We do that, right? We can do that. Okay, we'll attach the link, and then you guys tell us what you think. Aww. But congratulations, baby girl.
Thank you.
Okay, so let's get it started.
Quick takes.
More amazing black people. Mm-hmm. Kenya Barris is leaving his ABC, the packet ABC. He is leaving this month. Is that crazy?
He's pulling the Shonda Rhimes.
He's pulling the Shonda Rhimes. All right, so sources say that he will remain executive producer for Black-ish on ABC and Grown-ish and Bestie on Freeform, but he has this deal that's going to be with Netflix that's going to be phenomenal.
Wow, I'm sure. So I'm sure they'll pay him a lot more, and he'll have more freedom, too.
Netflix is just like all the cash. They're changing everything up. They are really changing it. Well, congratulations, Kenya. Congratulations.
Yes, congratulations. And congratulations are in order for Tamron Hall. So, yes. So, she is on her way back to daytime. She's inked a deal with Disney for a new daytime talk show. And this is what she had to say in a statement. She said, I'm so thrilled to partner with Disney ABC to create a daytime television show that's unconventional, fun, intimate, and sometimes even raw. My new partners appreciate and respect the relationship I've built with my audience. Shady, huh?
She dab built them. Go ahead, Tamron. I'ma just dab on you a little bit.
I've built with my audience and know that if we create television worth watching, they'll join us for the ride. I'm so grateful and excited for this next chapter. The landing makes the leap of faith so worth it. So congratulations to Tamron. I can't wait to see your show.
Yes, congratulations. Yeah. Other superheroes, Will Smith. Right, so if you've been following Will Smith, you guys have been following Will Smith on social media because he's becoming like a guru, like this positivity guru thing. So he is partnered with Mark Manson, and they're shopping a book deal.
Oh.
Yeah, so he said.
What is he going to write? He's
self-help stuff. So he said that he's going to shop around, and they're going to go with the highest bidder, of course. But I think that's refreshing. He's a bit of a black Jim Carrey on social media now.
Yeah, kind of like that guru type person.
Zen, just be as positive as you can. That
I
kind of
saw like little bits of that early on. Like, you know, he would always be kind of this positive thinking, kind of positive energy type person. So this is a good look for Will.
And then that's good, right, for the Red Table, right? Because now Jada's doing the Red Table on Facebook. Mm-hmm. So, and she's like spilling all the tea, which is a great show too. So good for you guys.
Power couple, yes.
Mm-hmm. Go ahead, Smiths.
All right. So, you know, I would love to talk about Meghan Markle and have it be positive, but once again, her family is acting shady. So the father and sister are still doing everything they can to cash in on her, you know, new celebrity and royalty. And now Meghan Markle's ex-husband is getting in on it. Ex-husband.
Well, all right. Hey, she had an ex-husband. They know it was coming.
I can't believe it. I'm like, that's so tacky. Like, why would you do something like that? Like, why?
But they did it to Diana. You don't remember they were, like, going into Diana's, like, closet and pulling out all kinds of old crap. They were setting her up. The media was setting her up. And remember they had that photo of her and you can see through her skirt. Like, the media does that to the new princess. That's just, she's getting her stripes.
Poor baby.
They didn't do it to Kate Middleton, right? They didn't do it to her.
Not at all.
Yeah, like she was like America's, well, the world's favorite.
They just didn't. I don't know. I just don't. There's something about her being American and her being the first black princess.
And then divorced and having a whole life.
Exactly. That makes her like fodder. And then she has obviously some like ratchet family members who are doing that. So, yeah.
Well, your ex-husband, you expect him to throw shade. Mm. I mean, come on. No? No?
That's terrible. That's okay. Terrible.
So, if you missed it, and if you did, you're under a rock. So, Beyonce, yes. Coachella, Mrs. Carter.
Everything.
Blues mom with the mother two kids.
The Louvre.
Green and purple. What's the other two kids' names?
Green and purple.
I don't know their names. Sorry. But I mean, she got remarried to Jay-Z again. Like, all things Beyonce is phenomenal and black power-ish, right?
Okay.
She took black girl magic and just, like, blew the shit up, actually, is what she did. So now, in Beyonce form, she is taking over Vogue. Mm-hmm. Right, so Beyonce, and you know, and so this September, all the magazines, black girls are just gracing
everywhere, everywhere, like
everywhere,
sleeping,
everywhere. Sleeping. Tiffany, everybody is,
yeah.
Everybody Haddish, is everywhere. Who else?
Issa Rae.
Issa Rae. Who mm-hmm. else? Who else? I know. What's this beautiful girl? Naomi Campbell.
That's a lot
I'm
of
talking about. I said beautiful girl. Naomi Campbell. Anyway, everybody is doing everything, right? But Beyonce is taking over Vogue, right?
Uh-huh.
So she is having all creative control over the cover, right? So she,
I heard about that. Yeah, definitely.
So now, so what she has is she picked a black photographer. Now this
black
is the thing.
Male.
Okay, so we can give him his name in a minute, but this has never happened before Vogue.
Ever.
Ever. It's 2018 Ever. Vogue. Like you, like okay. Okay.
Tyler Mitchell.
How old is this? Like 23
he's
years old.
23
right?
years old. The first time ever that a black man has been a photographer.
And Beyonce
for
had to pick
cover.
Him, right? Like, yeah. I'm telling you, when Beyonce did that, that Super Bowl, and she did all that black power, she tricked you white people. Because white people are like, wait a minute.
Remember the Saturday Night Live skit?
It was like, Beyonce's like, black. Beyonce's black.
Yeah,
Beyonce
exactly.
is very much
yes,
Louisiana. Louisiana.
Hot sauce in your bag. Swag.
Your bag,
okay.
Kinda black girl now. Like, don't let that light skin fool you. Beyonce, go ahead, Beyonce. So we're happy about that.
Yes, and congratulations to Tyler Mitchell. This man is going to go up from here. It's a great break for him.
Can you imagine Beyonce like, hey, this be
and
you're
like, what?
It is.
You'd be like, what? It's like getting a call from Oprah. Be on the floor.
I'll be like, I've been waiting for you.
Oh.
If Oprah called me, I'd be like, first of all, bitch, what took you so long? You know how long I thought you was gonna call me Oprah? You picking all these people.
Girl. Oh,
if Oprah called me, I'm gonna give a mouthful first. I'm like, first of all, Oprah.
We gonna see. Now I just wanna call up Oprah to get her to call her to
but
see what
Oprah,
Onika would say.
I would say,
and
Oprah,
she'd be on the floor.
What took you so long,
she'd be on the
first
floor.
Of all? And I'm coming over. Like, where are you staying? Like, send me your address. You know, like, put it with the zip code so I can have, like, Google Maps just take me there. Like, yeah, Oprah, I'm uh-huh. just saying.
You just talking.
I would. All right. Oprah called me. I've been fantasizing. Her, Beyonce, Jay-Z have all been my friends for a very long time. Very long. We have been rolling for a long time.
Okay.
And Oprah just don't call. Like, I don't get it.
You just talking. You know who else is talking? Kay Michelle
what
is talking.
Talking
yes. So, she, you know, I did not know this, but she had a relationship with Idris Elba.
Oh, I knew that.
In 2014 for a few months. That was like... Like
I think it
minute.
Was longer than a
no,
few
it was
months,
a few
Kizzy.
Months.
What y'all think? I
it
think it was longer
few,
than a few months because
no.
she's can't raise a man. That was for Idris. Okay,
it was
but
a
go
few
ahead.
Months. Okay, so it was a few months, and now she told Hollywood Unlocked that uh-huh. they split up because he wasn't ready to settle down.
Oh,
right?
He is not. Who? Idris Elba?
At the time, which was 2014, he's now married, but that's 2018.
So why is she talking about him now?
She had a lot to say, which we're not going to talk about here. But what you got to do is go to the interview and see what she had to say.
What did she All say? Right. Did she say anything about his sex game? Because I think it would be a phenomenal.
Of course.
She
of
talked
course.
About it?
Of course she did. Of course she did.
Oh, his
but we're not going to say why it was phenomenal. See, that's why you got to go to the interview. Check it out for yourself.
I can imagine he's British and what? Tall and a DJ. Scratch that thing. Yeah, Felicia. Oh, sorry.
What the? Wow. So what we can say is this. This is what she told Hollywood Unlocked. He told me he would never be committed to one woman. He said I would be taken care of. I would be fine, but he would never commit to one woman.
I don't even understand why would you need that with Idris Elba anyway. That other girl probably said, okay, you know, some, what they say, a one man's treasure is another man's trash or something like that.
Isn't it the reverse?
Or something. Whatever it is, guess what? If Idris Elba, let me speak English. If Idris Elba said, Onique, it's going to be three of y'all, and you can have me on Wednesday and Saturday, I'll be okay with it.
Oh, God.
It's Idris Elba. I don't have to really worry about money.
So you want to share your man?
Well, you already sharing them. These broke dudes. You be sharing them broke dudes. I mean, they have nothing, and you're sharing them. They just don't tell you.
Oh, God. You I'm see? Saying, well, just, damn. Well,
let's
damn.
Tell the truth and shame the devil.
Oh, God. You see? That's terrible. Okay. That's terrible.